सो आई नो आई होप दैट ऑल ऑफ यू नो द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज सेशन. आप सभी को आज के सेशन का टॉपिक पता होगा. सो द टॉपिक फॉर टुडेज सेशन इज रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशंस. एंड यस्टरडे वी फिनिश्ड आवर क्लास एट अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 9 PM एंड वी हैव नॉट नाउ स्टार्टेड द नेक्स्ट सेशन बिकॉज आई वॉन्टेड ऑल ऑफ यू टू एटलीस्ट गो थ्रू सम प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट सेशन. मैं चाहता था कि आप सभी लोग कुछ प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन को चेक करें एंड आफ्टर दिस प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन I wanted to cover more topics. ठीक है. So I think we can start our session. Do you have any questions so far जो हम लोग कर सकते हैं. I've already sent you the PDF file of this lecture in the Telegram channel. तो Telegram channel पे let me again forward the same. तो मैं Telegram channel पे और फिर से दोबारा से forward कर देता हूँ so that you guys can get it. Okay, just hold on a second. Let me again forward this same PDF in the Telegram channel ताकि आप सभी को दोबारा से मिल जाए. Great. So I have forwarded this PDF file in the Telegram channel again so that all of you can find the same file, right? So hi Mansa, hi Sakshi, hi Jyoti, Priyanka, Neetu, Madhu, Abhay, Ankit, and here we have Jyoti, Gaurav, Surya, Ranjan, Divesh, Ramya, and Shanti. Correct. So hi Kajol, how are you? So I think we can start the session, right? Because I think all of you are available. आप सभी आ चुके हैं तो हम लोग अपने session को start कर सकते हैं. We can start our session. So as I said in my previous classes that I'm going to repeat every sentence in Hindi as well as in English so that everybody can get benefited from this. जो हिंदी speakers हैं उनको भी इसका benefit मिलना चाहिए और जो English speaker है उनको भी इसका benefit मिलना चाहिए, right? So let us do this topic, regular expressions, and this topic is in theory of computation. ठीक है. So far we have seen a lot of things. हम लोग काफ़ी चीज़ें चेक कर चुके हैं. We have seen a lot of things. Now in this lecture we will be having the following objectives. हम लोग ये सभी चीज़ें कवर करेंगे. We are going to have these following objectives. Number one, we will be studying the concept of regular expressions. So that is, what is a regular expression? How can you represent a regular expression? This is your first session. Then we'll be looking at the construction of finite automata from a regular expression. That means if I give a regular expression of any sort, maybe the regular expression is something like this. We have a plus b star plus b ab star whole star. Let us suppose if we have a regular expression like this. Now I want to convert this regular expression to finite automata. I can easily do it. So we will look at this conversion. Hum log is conversion ke baare mein apni class mein discuss karenge. That means how to convert the finite automata from a, I mean how to convert the regular expression to a finite automata, as well as how can you convert a regular finite automata to a regular expression. So two things are here. The first one is regular expression to finite automata. Second is finite automata to regular expression. How can you do this conversion? And third, we are going to look at this pumping lemma for regular sets, or you can say regular languages. पंपिंग लेमा क्या है वो हम लोग डिस्कस करेंगे एंड देन सम ऑफ द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशंस. सो अगेन लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स कैन बी डन यूजिंग दिस रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन. लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स कैन बी डन, राइट? एंड देन वी विल लुक एट मे बी सम क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन. सो दिस क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टीज मे बी वी विल कवर, बट आई थिंक इन योर फर्स्ट सेशन वी विल बी कवरिंग दीज टॉपिक्स. सो वी विल बी हैविंग अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 3 sessions टूडे एंड एवरी सेशन विल बी ऑफ 1.5 hours ईच. तो जो आपका पहला सेशन है उस फर्स्ट सेशन में हम लोग ये पहले 3 topics को कवर करेंगे, विच इज़ द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन, एफ ए टू आर ई, आर ई टू एफ ए, एंड देन पंपिंग लेमा, एंड मे बी इन द सेकेंड सेशन वी विल लुक एट सम ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज हियर. ठीक है. सो आई थिंक वी कैन स्टार्ट. फाइन, ऑल ऑफ यू आर रेडी? अगर सभी लोग रेडी है प्लीज़ राइट रेडी इन द चैट विंडो. इफ ऑल ऑफ यू आर रेडी विद योर नोटबुक्स पेन एंड पेपर प्लीज राइट रेडी इन द चैट विंडो. ग्रेट ग्रेट ग्रेट. सो ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज आर रेडी. सो आई नीड रिप्लाइज फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज. सभी की तरफ से रिप्लाई चाहिए. आई गॉट रिप्लाई फ्रॉम लोफला, सोनिया, निर्जा, चेतना, ज्योति, मधु, काजोल, साक्षी, नीतू एंड मानसा. ग्रेट. एंड रामिया ऑल्सो. ग्रेट. एंड प्रियंका. वेरी गुड. सो वी हैव सीन 2 important कॉन्सेप्ट सो फार. सबसे पहला जो कॉन्सेप्ट हमने देखा था, द फर्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी हैव सीन इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा. एंड द सेकेंड कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी हैव सीन सो फार is the concept of push down automata, that is your PDA. Now I told you the languages accepted by finite automata is called as a regular language, right? So let me also write it in complete. It is a regular language. And the languages accepted by the Pushdown Automata are called as context-free language. These are called as context-free languages. Okay. There is regular languages and second one is context-free language. Okay. Now in this case, if I give you any kind of language whatsoever, if you can make a finite automata for this language, that means the language is regular. But if you cannot make a finite automata of, or if nobody can ever make a finite automata for some language, for that language, then I will say the language is not regular, right? So basically, this finite automata and this regular language, both are interrelated to each other. In the same way, this regular expression is also interrelated to regular language. Regular expressions are used to represent a regular language. Ek regular language ko represent karne ke liye hum regular expression ka use karte hain. Okay? What do I mean to say by this? Dekho, when we say that we have a finite automata, so this finite automata is basically an acceptor. Ye jo finite automata hai, ye ek acceptor ka kaam karta hai. Acceptor means if you give a string in the finite automata, then the string will tell whether this string is present in the language or this string is not present in the language. Jab bhi aapko string denge uske andar, to wo batayega ki ye jo string hai, ye is language ke andar present hai ya fir ye string is language ke andar present nahi hai. Fine. In the same way, when you create a regular expression, when you create this regular expression, so this regular expression is just used to represent that regular language. Ye sirf us language ko represent karne ke liye use hota hai. Okay, is it clear so far? Itna aap sabhi ke sath clear hai? Great. Itna clear hai sabhi ke sath? Very good, very good. So now we have seen many examples here. We have seen a DFA, right? And we have seen this epsilon NFA. Now you can convert this epsilon NFA to NFA without epsilon symbol. And further, this NFA without epsilon symbol can also be converted to a DFA. And this DFA can be converted to a regular expression. And further, this regular expression can be converted to NFA with epsilon symbol. So basically, it is kind of a cycle, right? ये पूरा एक cycle की तरह है कि अगर आपके पास एक regular expression है, तो उस regular expression को आप NFA में convert कर सकते हैं. That is NFA with epsilon move, and then you can change this NFA to NFA without epsilon move, and then this NFA without epsilon move to DFA, and then again, so this everything can go like this. So that means this regular expression here, it is just used to represent the language. So ye bas language ko represent karne ke liye use hota hai and nothing else. That's it. So you should know what is the use of regular expressions here. Theek hai? So here in the regular expressions, we have few basic operations. So we will look at all of these operations one by one. Hum sab ke baare mein ek ek karke check karenge. So first of all, in a regular expression, there are some primitive elements. Primitive elements means the elements which are, I mean, the basic element. I mean, just like if you say in a programming language, jis tarah se aapke paas ek programming language hai, in a programming language, you have a primitive variables. So what are your primitive variables? Your arrays are not primitive variables. These are, you know, created using primitive elements, right? So for example, you have character, you have integer, you have float, you have double. These are primitive elements. Now using these elements, you can create different kind of structures of these elements. For example, array is a structure of these elements. Even if you take a tree, even if you take a linked list, these are the structure of these elements, right? So those structures are created using a primitive elements only. In the same way, when you look at a regular expression, in this regular expression, we have a few primitive elements. So for example, phi is a primitive element. This epsilon symbol is a primitive element. And then you have a few more extra elements here, right? For example, here we are using some operations, which is addition. Addition is used for union. And when we also have a star here, and we also have a dot, which is representing clean closure. Okay. Now let me explain you each of these things one by one, then I will again come back to this slide and I will again teach it, right? So first of all, let me give a little basic regarding this. After giving you a little basic, then I will come back to this one. Okay? So in your regular expression, we have phi. So phi is a primitive element, and you know what is a phi? Phi represents a language which is having no strings, or you can say phi represents an empty set. We already know this. We have already seen a lot of examples based on this. When I say we have epsilon, जब मैं बोलता हूँ कि हमारे पास epsilon है, so this epsilon means it is a string of length 0. So that means summation raised to power 0 represents epsilon. Okay? Let us assume that your summation is having two symbols, which is A and B. आपका जो summation है वो दो symbols है उसके अंदर. There is a symbol A as well as the symbol B. Now, when I say that your language is having the symbol A and your symbol B, so that means we are taking a union of both A and B. And this union in a regular expression is represented by a symbol plus. हम union को plus symbol से represent करते हैं. So the union is represented by the symbol plus. Okay? In the same way, when we use the operation concatenation, so this concatenation is represented by the symbol dot. So you have three important operations here in the regular expression. The first operation is union, the second operation is concatenation, and the third operation here is your clen closure. Which is represented by a star. So let me explain you all of them step by step. Fine. Let us suppose that in your language you have the strings which is A, B plus B, I mean AB comma BA, AB comma BA comma AA comma BB. So these are four strings which are present in your language. Now, if I want to create a regular expression for this, that means I have to take a union of all of these four. So mujhe in charon ka union lena padega. That means in the regular expression for this given language, I'm going to take AB plus BA plus AA plus BB. Okay? So which is a union of all of these elements. Now, here I can take something as common. I can take, so for example, I can take this one and I can take this one and I can take A as common from them. At the same time, I can take these two and I can take B as common. So that means this can also be written as, if I take A as common, then it will be B plus A. And then here from these two, if I take B as common, then again it will be A plus B. Right? So this plus operator, which is union operation, is a commutative operator. Ye aapka commutative operator hai. So what do you mean by commutative operator? It means that when I say A plus B, then it is equivalent to saying B plus A. So it is a commutative operator. Therefore, this one, which is B plus A, is also equivalent to A plus B. Therefore, I can take A plus B as common. And here also, I can take A plus B as common. Clear? So here, this thing here, it is representing the regular expression. Now, in this regular expression, I have taken two operations. मैंने यहाँ पर दो operations को लिया है. I have taken two operations here. The first operation here is this union operation. हमने एक union operation को लिया है. And the second operation here, this symbol, which is your dot symbol. So this dot symbol is representing your concatenation. ये आपका concatenation operation को represent कर रहा है. Right? So basically, if you want to create a regular expression for any language, so in that regular expression, we are going to have this union operation, we are going to have this concatenation operation, and the third operation that we are going to have is a clen closure operation, right? Clen closure. So I told you what is a clen closure earlier also. Main aapko pehle bhi bata chuka hoon. Let me find a white page and I can again show you the clen closure. Okay, let me find a white page here. I think I should use this page. Let us use this page, right? So I told you that we have a clen closure operation, and this clen closure operation is represented by star. So for example, if I have a symbol A and if I take a clean closure of A, so this clean closure of A represents all the possible strings of A. I mean, this represents the string which is epsilon, string of length 0. It also represents the string of length 1, which is A. It also represents string of length 2, which is a double A. It also represents the string of length 3, which is a triple A, and so on. Okay. Now, I've already told you this before also. We have already covered it before. That is why I'm just covering it as a revision so that you all remember what is a clean closure operation. I told you earlier. So let us suppose that we have summation is equal to A comma B. So if I take summation star means this star represents your clean closure operation. Ye jo hai, ye aapka clean closure operation ko represent kar raha hai. This is representing your clean closure operation. So if I take this clean closure operation, that means it is summation raised to power 0 union summation raised to power 1 union summation raised to power 2 union summation raised to power 3 union up to so on till infinity, right? So it will be the union of all of these summations. In sabhi summations ka jo hai wo union hoga, that is infinite union of summation raised to power 0, summation raised to power 1, summation raised to power 2, and so on. In the same way, when I do this A star, so this A star means it is the union of A raised to power 0, union A raised to power 1, union A raised to power 2, union A raised to power 3, union, and so on till infinity. So when I say A raised to power 2, it means double A. When I say A raised to power 3, it means triple A. So that means I'm going to get all of these strings only. Mujhe yehi sabhi strings yahan par milegi. So I told you that we have three fundamental operations so far. What are the operations? We have an operation which is plus, that represents union. We have the operation which is dot, that represent concatenation. And the third operation that we have seen is star, which is your clean closure operation. Clean closure operation, right? So any regular language whatsoever, any regular language can be, you know, expressed using these three operations. Hum kisi bhi regular language ko in teen operations se express kar sakte hain. Right? Clear so far? Is it clear with everyone? So any regular language can be expressed using these three operations, and these three operations are union, concatenation, and clean closure. Now come back to the previous slide here and let us go through the previous slide once again. Maybe we can find out a lot of things in the previous slide. So here let us read the theory again. We'll read the theory again. So here, first of all, when I say phi represents an empty set. When I say epsilon represents a string of length 0. When I say that we have R is a regular expression as well as S is a regular expression. This R is a regular expression for the language L1, and this S is a regular expression for the language L2, right? So here R is representing a regular expression as well as S is also representing a regular expression. Now in this case, if I do R plus S, agar main yahan par R plus S ko leta hun, if I do R plus S, this R plus S operation is representing the union, correct? So that is a union operation. There is language L1, union language L2. When I take R dot S, so here between this R and S, we have a dot operation. So that means it is a concatenation of both of these two languages, which is L1 and L2. When I take R star, it means the clean closure. So I can take the clean closure of the language L1, right? So this again, you can see this is representing a clean closure operation. Now there are few identities of these regular expressions. Inki kuch identities hai. Let us look at these identities one by one. So the first identity says that if R is a regular expression here, so here wherever I'm using R, that means R is representing a regular expression, right? So if R is a regular expression, then if I do phi plus R, then it is equivalent to R. So phi is representing an empty set and R is representing a regular expression. That means agar aap ek empty set ka kisi regular expression ke saath union lenge, then you will get the same regular expression. Aapko same regular expression hi milegi. Next, if I do phi dot R, where phi is representing an empty set and R is representing a regular expression, then it will be equal to R dot phi, which is equal to phi only, jo ki phi ke equal hi hai, which is representing an empty set. Next, if I do lambda dot R, then R dot lambda is equal to R. So here this lambda means epsilon, or you can say string of length 0. राइट. सो जहाँ से मैंने इसको कॉपी किया, आई मीन आई हैव कॉपीड दिस वन. सो जहाँ से मैंने इसको कॉपी किया, दे आर यूजिंग लैम्डा. सो बेसिकली दिस इज फ्रॉम द बुक विच इज KLP मिश्रा. ये मैंने KLP मिश्रा से लिया, टेकन दिस फ्रॉम KLP मिश्रा. सो इन KLP मिश्रा इंस्टेड ऑफ यूजिंग दिस एप्सिलॉन ऑपरेटर, दे वर यूजिंग अ लैम्डा ऑपरेटर. ओके, सो दे वर यूजिंग लैम्डा ऑपरेटर टू रिप्रेजेंट स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 0. क्लियर? सो इफ यू टेक कॉन्कैट एनी रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन एंड इफ यू कॉन्कैटिनेट इट विद एन स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 0 विच इज योर एप्सिलॉन ऑपरेटर, देन दैट इज इक्वलेंट टू द सेम रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन ओनली. फाइन. नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन हियर इज योर नेक्स्ट वन हियर इज अगेन स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 0, एंड इफ यू टेक अ यू नो क्लैन क्लोज ऑफ स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 0, देन यू विल गेट स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 0 ओनली. और इन अदर वर्ड्स यू कैन, इफ यू टेक अ एप्सिलॉन स्टार, देन दिस एप्सिलॉन स्टार इज इक्वलेंट टू एप्सिलॉन. एप्सिलॉन स्टार जो है वो एप्सिलॉन के ही इक्वलेंट है. सो बोथ ऑफ देम आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग द सेम थिंग. ओके, नेक्स्ट इफ यू टेक phi स्टार, वेयर phi इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग एन एम्प्टी सेट, एंड इफ यू टेक द स्टार ऑफ एन एम्प्टी सेट, देन यू विल गेट दिस यू नो स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 0. देन इफ यू टेक टू रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशंस विच आर एग्जैक्टली द सेम, दोनों रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन अगर एग्जैक्टली सेम है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई टेक ए प्लस ए, सो हियर दिस ए एंड दिस ए बोथ आर एग्जैक्टली द सेम. सो ए प्लस ए इज एक्चुअली इक्वलेंट टू ए ओनली, बिकॉज दिस इज अ यूनियन ऑपरेटर. सो इन अ यूनियन ऑपरेटर वी डू नॉट टेक एनी रिपीटेड वैल्यूज. ओके, सो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस अगेन वन मोर टाइम. Let us assume that we have a set A, and this set A is having the elements 1, 3 and 5. And you have a set B which is having the elements 2, 3 and 7. So if I take A union B, in that case we will get the elements which is 1, 2, 3, 5 and 7. Now look at it here very carefully. This 3 is coming 2 times. So but again in the union I have only mentioned it only once. Right, because in a set repeated elements cannot be there, we do not take repeated elements in a set. So in the same way here, if I do R union with R, then I will get R only, which is your same regular expression. Clear? So next, if we do R star dot R star, then it is equal to R star only. Okay? So yes, phi dot r is equal to r dot phi is equal to phi madhu. I think this is your doubt. So ye sabhi equivalent hai. If you do phi with r or r with phi, you will get phi only. And this is not representing phi, this is representing string of length 0, which is your epsilon. So ye jo hai string of length 0 ko represent kar raha hai, jo ki epsilon hai. Fine. Then if I do r dot r star, so that is if I do a dot a star, so this is actually equivalent to saying a star dot a. Basically this concatenation operation is not commutative. Concatenation operation jo hai ye aapka commutative operation nahi hai. Let me give a brief idea about it. When I do a union operation, that means if I do a plus b, then it is equivalent to saying b plus a, because this union operation is commutative. But when I do concatenation, that means A dot B, then it is not equivalent to saying B dot A. So this concatenation operation is not at all commutative. Yeah, but concatenation operation jo hai, ye commutative nahi hai. This is something that you should know. Ye aapko pata hona chahiye. Fine. Now in this case, when I do A dot A star, then it is equivalent to A star dot A. And it can also be written as A plus. Isko hum A plus se bhi likh sakte hai. So we have two operations here. One is your star operation, which is called as clen closure. So in the clen closure operation, we also have string of length 0. But when I do A plus or R plus, here we do not get a string of length 0. So yahan pa string of length 0 nahi aati. Let me explain this to you step by step. Let me try my best so that I can explain this to you very clearly. Okay. So if I say that we have A star. So A star means it is A raised to power 0 union A raised to power 1 union A raised to power 2 union A raised to power 3 up to so on, right? And we change this union operation
with a plus operator, right? So this can also be written as a raised to power 0 plus a raised to power 1 plus a raised to power 2 plus up to so on till infinity.
And we know what is this a raised to power 0? A raised to power 0 means it is epsilon. So that means this a star, that is Klein closure of a, can be written as epsilon plus a plus double a plus triple a and so on. But when I do a plus operator, so a plus operator is little different from a star. So a plus operator is actually equivalent to saying a raised to power 1 plus a raised to power 2 plus a raised to power 3 plus up to so on infinity, or you can say it is a plus aa plus triple a plus up to so on till infinity. Correct? Clear? Now in this case, when I write a star, so a star means we are concatenating a with a star, right? So this a star dot a, I mean when I write a plus, then a plus means we can concatenate a star with a. So it can be written as a star dot a is equivalent to a plus, as well as it is also equivalent to a dot a star. Okay, so that is why these are same. इसी वजह से ये सभी same है. Clear? Now in the same manner, when you look at this regular expression here, so it is also representing, which is r plus. So r is representing a regular expression, right? तो ये r plus के equivalent होगा. So we'll look at this in more details, lot of details. We'll take lot of details, or we'll discuss each of these topics in lot of details. Then you will understand what I'm trying to say. Okay. Now next one here is r star whole star. So that means if I do something like this, if I take a star and if I again take a star of this, then it is equivalent to a star only. Ye a star ke hi equal hai. So that is why this is equal to r star. Okay. If I do epsilon plus r star dot r. Now look at it very, very carefully. Thoda dhyan se samajhiyega. Look at it very carefully. When I write a plus, so this a plus means here we do not have epsilon. When I write a star, this a star means here we also have epsilon. Now if we do something like this, hum agar kuch aisa kare, if we do a plus plus epsilon, a plus plus epsilon, right? So, or in other words, I can also write it this in this manner. So I have a plus operation and this is plus epsilon, then it is equivalent to epsilon plus a plus double a plus up to so on to infinity. Therefore, if I write a star, then a star will be equivalent to saying a plus plus epsilon. Yani ki a plus ke saath agar aap epsilon ko union le denge, if you take a union of epsilon with a star, then it will, if you take a union of epsilon with a plus, then it will become a star. So a star ke equal hoga. Okay, clear? Yes, Shubham, what is your doubt? Yes, Ramya, what is your doubt? So therefore, here you can clearly see this equation can also be written as r star, which can also be written as epsilon plus r star dot r. Isko hum epsilon plus r star dot r ke equal bhi likh sakte hain. We can also write it in this manner. Theek hai? Next is this equation. That means if I had to say pq whole star dot p, then it can be written as p dot qp whole star. Isko hum p dot qp whole star bhi likh sakte hain. We can also write it in this manner. Okay, so don't worry, some of these identities will not be very clear to you, because you will learn most of these identities with the help of examples. Right now just treat them as mathematical formulas, that's it. Then after this lecture, after I will take a few examples, I will come back to these identities and I will explain you these identities again. Main aapko sabhi identities jo hai dobara se explain karunga. Then you will see, you will understand each of these identities very clearly. Okay? Okay. Yes, concatenation is not commutative. So, but here this is an identity. Why this is an identity? I will prove you. So, hum log isko proof dekhenge. We will also look at the proof of this identity. Right? So, because even we know that commutative is, concatenation is not commutative, but still this identity holds. And why it holds, that I will explain you. कि क्यों होल्ड करता है, आई एक्सप्लेन यू बाय एंड हाउ. ठीक है, ओके, सो again, these are again two more identities. We will be using these identities, for example, so we'll be using these identities very frequently, right? So there's something called Arden's method or Arden's theorem also that we will also be using. But here there's something very interesting here, right? Dekho, let me explain you something here. If I say that we have summation is equal to a comma b, that means in our language we have two symbols, which is a and b, correct? Summation is equal to a comma b, that means in our language we have two symbols, which is a and b. So if first of all, when I say that language is strings of length one, so that can also be written as summation raised to power 1. Therefore, the strings that will be here in this language is a comma b only. Now for this language, what will be the regular expression? Is language ke regular expression kya rahegi? So this regular expression can be written as a plus b. So all you have to do is you have to take the union of both the elements which are present in the language. Clear? Now if I say the language is w such that the length of w is equivalent to, or length of w is exactly 2. The length of w is exactly 2. And here this language is also based on this summation. Woh isi summation ke upar based hai. So therefore, in this language, what are the strings? The strings can be AA, comma AB, comma BA, comma BB. So there will be 4 strings. So if I take a regular expression for this language, so the regular expression means I have to take a union of both all of them. And in this case, when I write this AA, so AA means there's automatically a concatenation operation here. Yahan par automatically a concatenation operation hai. We automatically have a concatenation operation in this case. So that means if I write a regular expression for this, it will be equal to AA plus AB plus BA plus BB, which can also be written as A plus B dot A plus B. So if you observe this clearly, then you will identify that this regular expression is for string of length 1 and this regular expression is for string of length 2. That means I have concatenated string of length 1 with again one more string of length 1 so that the total length will become 2, right? So this is this part here. Let me change the color also. So this part here, it is representing string of length 1. I'm concatenating this string of length 1 with another string of length 1. So after doing this concatenation operation, then you'll get this, you know, string of length 2. Fit and fine. Now, if I take one more language, so language is a raised to power n such that n is greater than or equal to 0, right? And this is also our summation is equal to a comma b. Summation is equal to a comma b per he hai, right? This is also one summation is equal to a comma b. So that means in this language we will have the following strings, which is epsilon comma a comma double a comma triple a and so on till infinity. Therefore, when I take a regular expression for this, so this regular expression will be a union of all of them. So that will be epsilon plus a plus double a plus triple a plus 4 times a and so on till infinity, which is equivalent to saying a star only, or you can say clean closure of a. Ye a ke clean closure ke equal hogi, right? So I've taken 3 examples here. In the first example, I have demonstrated the use of union. Yahan par maine union ka use demonstrate kiya. In this second example, I have demonstrated the use of concatenation. And your third example, I have demonstrated the use of the clean closure operation. So we have seen the use of these of all these 3 operations. Right? Itna clear hai sabhi ke sath? Is it clear so far? Now after this, I will take more examples of languages and I will try to make little more complicated, some more complicated regular expressions, because these are very basic and very simple regular expressions. I have to take more complicated expressions, right? So itni easy expressions, you will not get these kind of easy expressions in your exam. Obviously, the expressions that you will get in your exam will be little more difficult as compared to this. So these are just very easy expressions for you guys. Okay, fine. Let us move forward. So I'm going to skip this Arnest method also. This is something that we have covered. Okay, and I think I've already covered this, all combinations of A. Yeah, so I think I already covered both of them, but still, just for your revision, I'm covering once again, right? So let me take this once again, just for the sake of completion, because I've included this in the PPT, I've sent you the PPT. So just for the sake of completion, let me do it, because I've already solved it. So first one is, all combinations of A's over summation is equal to A. All combinations of A's, right? So that means here the language L1 will be having epsilon, comma A, comma double A, comma triple A, comma four times A, and so on till infinity, which is representing your regular expression A star. So the regular expression for the language L1 is A star. In the same way, secondly, all combinations of A's except the null string. A ke jitne bhi combination hai, wo sabhi except a null string, right? So that means here, all of these combinations will come, but the only difference here is this epsilon will not be there. Therefore, it can also be written as language L2 can also be written as A, comma double A, comma triple A, comma four times A, and so on till infinity. And this L2 can also be written as A plus. Hum isko regular expression A plus se bhi represent kar sakte hain. We can also represent this with A plus, or you can say, you can also represent this regular expression using A dot A star. Okay? And then you must be asking, why sir I'm concatenating A with A star? Sir, hum A with A ko A star ke saath hum kyun concatenate kar rahe? You might be asking this kind of question. Why sir? Why are you doing such, sir? Why are you not explaining this to us, sir? Let me explain you this. So here, when I take this A, so I have this one, and when I take this A star means it is the union of all of A epsilon comma A comma A plus plus and so on. That means this A star can also be written as epsilon plus A plus double A plus triple A plus up to so on till infinity. Then I will say, sir, now you can concatenate this A with each one of them individually. आप इस A को इन सभी के साथ individually concatenate कर सकते हैं. Now you can concatenate this A with each one of them individually. That means I'm going to concatenate this A with this one. I'm going to concatenate this A with this one. I'm going to concatenate with this one. I'm going to concatenate with this one. Right? Therefore, this can also be written as A plus double A plus triple A and so on. Right? So if you do A dot epsilon, that is equal to A dot A, that is equal to double A dot double A, that is equal to triple A and so on. Therefore, both of them are actually equivalent. Right? So I hope it is clear. Itna clear aap sabhi ke saath, let us move forward after this. Okay. Now the next language is all strings containing any number of A's and B's over A comma B. We can have any number of A as well as we can also have any number of B. That means this language contains strings of length 0, strings of length 1, strings of length 2, strings of length 3 and so on. Right, so here what is written? Summation is equal to A comma B. So I told you, when you take summation star, so this summation star means summation raised to power 0 union summation raised to power 1 union summation raised to power 2 union summation raised to power 3 union up to so on till infinity. This is what you can do, right? And that means summation star represents all possible strings over summation. ये क्या represent करता है कि summation के ऊपर जितने भी strings possible है, I'm going to represent all those possible strings over summation here. So we can have summation any length of the string, length 0, length 1, length 2, length 3, length 4, length 5, length 6, and so on. You can have any length of the string whatsoever. So when I take summation star means all the possible strings over summation. That's it. इसका सिर्फ इतना सा meaning है. Okay. Now in this case, I know what is summation star, right? And I know what is summation. So summation represents a comma b. Therefore, if you are going to represent a regular expression for summation, then that will be equal to a plus b, right? So what I have to do is just replace this summation with this a plus b. Isko sirf a plus b se replace karo. Therefore, I'm going to get a plus b whole star. A plus b whole star. Now, what do you mean by a plus b whole star? So this a plus b whole star means it is a plus b raised to power 0 plus a plus b raised to power 1 plus a plus b raised to power 2 plus a plus b raised to power 3 plus up to so on till infinity. Okay, I hope it is clear so far. Itna sabhi ke saath clear hoga. Now, if it is clear, so these are very basic things, right? So, bahut basic cheeze hain. So, I'm starting everything from very, very basics so that you can understand every concept very clearly, right? My aim is to make you understand every concept clearly, right? So in this case, when I say a plus b raised to power 0, what do you mean by this? When I say a plus b raised to power 0, that means string of length 0. So it represents epsilon plus. When I say a plus b raised to power 1, that means it represents strings of length 1, which is a plus b. When I say a plus b raised to power 2, that means strings of length 2. So what are the strings of length 2? Strings of length 2 means it is AA, AB, BA and BB. So which is equal to AA plus AB plus BA plus BB plus. What do you mean by A plus B raised to power 3? It means strings of length 3, which is equivalent to AAA plus AAB and so on till infinity. Right? So that means if I take A plus B whole star, it generates all possible combination of A and B. A और B के ऊपर जितने भी possible combination है, ये उन सभी combinations को represent करता है. Clear? Is it clear with everyone? So A plus B whole star represents all possible strings over the alphabet A and B. इतना आप सभी के साथ clear है? I hope it is clear with all of you. Any doubt so far? कब तक कोई doubt है? Great. So I'll take a lot of examples. Ramya, so obviously each of these examples, all of these examples will get clear one by one. So let me take all of these examples, right? Once I take these examples, everything will get clear step by step. It's even if one example is not clear, I have so many examples that at least one example will strike. You will easily understand the concept. This is what I mean to say. Okay? Okay, now let us look at the next one. All strings having any number of A's and any number of B's except the null string. Hame sabhi string ko lena hai, but we do not have to take, we have to skip the null string. That means the answer is A plus B plus. Correct? And which is also equivalent to A plus B dot A plus B whole star, which is also equivalent to saying a plus b whole star dot a plus b. So that's it. It is a solution. Okay. Very easy problem. Very easy question, right? Okay. Let us take the next example after this. Next one is all the strings which are ending with double zero over the set, which is 0, 1s. So I want the strings that should end with double zero. Jitni bhi string double zero se end hoti hai, I want all of those strings, right? So first of all, let us understand what are the strings that will be present here. Kaun kaun se string hai jo yahan par present hongi? It is all the strings which are ending with double zero. So that means we can have the string which is double zero, because it is ending with double zero, it is starting with double zero as well as ending with double zero. We can also have a string which is triple zero. It is ending with double zero. We can also have the string which is 100, ending with double zero. We can also have the string which is 0000, right? We can have 0100. We can have 1000. We can have 1100 and so on. So every string that will end with double zero, that will be present here. Jo bhi string double zero se end hogi, wo sabhi string yahan par present hongi. Okay. Clear? So that means, can I do something like this? That I can concatenate this double zero with all other strings. Matlab, I can find string of length 0, I can find string of length 1, I can find string of length 2, I can concatenate with double zero. So if I just write here, what is the symbol? It is epsilon, right? Here we have a symbol 0. Here we have a symbol 1. Here we have a symbol double 0. Here we have a symbol 0, 1. Here we have a symbol 1, 0. Here we have a symbol which is 1, 1. And then we can have a symbol which is 3 times 0 and so on till infinity. Right, so this is representing all the possible strings, all the alphabet 0, 1. 0, 1 alphabet pe jitne bhi possible string hai, it represents all of those possible strings. Now in this particular case, what I can do is I can write a regular expression to represent all of these, and then I can concatenate this with double zero. Main isko double zero ke saath concatenate kar sakta hun. That means I can write it in this manner. We can have 0 + 1 whole star concatenated with double zero. 0 + 1 whole star concatenated with double zero, because this 0 + 1 whole star represents all the possible combinations of 0 and 1 from all the length 0, length 1, length 2, length 3, length 4, up to so on till infinity. So it represents all the possible combinations of zeros and one, and concatenating it with the operation double zero. Clear? Okay. Nancy, don't worry, I'll take all of these doubts. Just follow through the lecture, you'll understand very clearly. You'll understand everything very easily. Just follow through the lecture. Very good. So let us take the next example here. Next example is saying all the strings which are starting with 1 and ending with 0. Jitni bhi strings hain, wo sabhi 1 se start hona chahiye aur 0 se end honi chahiye, right? Starting with 1 and ending with 0. So that means if I take this language L6, what are the strings which are present in this language L6? Kaun kaun si strings hain jo is language L6 ke andar present hongi? So strings that will be present here, we can have starting with 1 and ending with 0. It is the smallest string. We can also have 1 double 0, starting with 1, ending with 0. We can also have 1 1 0, starting with 1, ending with 0. We can also have 1 double 0 0, starting with 1, ending with 0. We can also have 1 0 1 0, starting with 1, ending with 0. We can also have 1 1 0 0. We can also have 1 1 1 0, and so on, right? So each of these strings here, they are starting with the symbol 1 and they are ending with the symbol 0. Starting with 1, ending with 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 0, and so on. So if you just take the middle part here, if you just take the middle part here, so here we have epsilon, here we have 0, here we have 1, here we have double 0, here we have 0, 1, here we have 1, 0, and here we have 1, 1. Correct? So this is again, in the middle portion, this is again representing all the possible combinations of zeros and 1. So therefore, this can also be represented in this manner: 1 concatenation with 0 + 1 whole star 0. Right? Because it should start with 1. As you can see, ye 1 se start hona chahiye, it should start with 1. It should end with 0. In middle, we can have any combination of 0 and 1. Middle mein hamare paas 0 aur 1 ka koi bhi combination aa sakta hai. I hope it is clear. Don't worry, Ramya and Nancy, I'll take your doubts one by one. Let me just go through the lecture first. Theek hai? Here any doubt? Neetu, Noflan, Ananya, Chetna, Madhu, Vandana, Priyanka, Ankit, Shubham, Mansa, good. So it is clear with everyone. So you guys are superstar, my superheroes, my amazing, you know, you guys are literally very amazing. Okay. Let us look at the next one here. So next one says starting and ending with A, any combination of B's in between. That means the starting symbol should be A, ending symbol should be A, but in between only B's should be there. Which may sirf B aa sakta hai, we cannot have any combination of A and B, right? So that means we can have the strings here, the strings will be A, B, A. We can also have a single A because it is starting with A, ending with A, and number of B's are 0.
We can also have ABA. We can also have double A because there is no B is there, right? So when I say, when they are saying any combination of B's, that means they also allow zero B. Zero means B raised power zero means string of length zero, right? So you have a string of length zero B allowed here. In the same way, we can also have A double BA. We can also have A triple BA and so on till infinity. Now in this case, if you see it clearly in B, in between we can have any combination of B, right? So starting symbol should be A, in between we can have any combination of B, and again the ending symbol should also be A. So ending symbol jo hai wo bhi aapke paas A hona chahiye, right? Good with everyone? Samajh aaya? It's a very very easy example, not such a difficult example. It's very very easy example and you can easily understand it, right? Next one, describe in the simple English the language represented by the following regular expression. What is the language? So this regular expression is representing A plus AB whole star. A plus AB whole star. Okay. So now your question will be answered. I think this question was asked by Nancy. So now your question will be answered very easily because of this. So when I say this star, that means I can replace this star with the powers. So this can also be written in this manner. This can be written as A plus AB raised to power 0 plus A plus AB raised to power 1 plus A plus AB raised to power 2 plus A plus AB raised to power 3 and so on till infinity, right? So it can also be presented in this manner. Now when I take raised to power 0, it means it is epsilon. Right, so jo pehla aapke paas hai, this is having a power 0, that means it is equivalent to epsilon. Then we have the second symbol, so which is equal to A plus AB, right? Then here it is representing length 2. Yahan par ye kya hai? It is representing your length 2. So that means if I take A plus AB dot A plus AB, so that is a total of length 2, right? So I can do a concatenation here. So if you do concatenation again, so then the concatenation will be equal to A dot A plus, right, double A B plus A B A plus A B A B, right? So A dot A dot A B, A B dot A B dot A B, correct? Is it clear so far? Itna clear aap sabhi ke saath? Right, then we have length 3. So length 3 means I'm going to concatenate this with length 3, right? So I mean length, one more length, right? So that can be written as A plus AB dot A plus AB square, right? But if you again check out this string, if you read this string properly and if you try to see what it is representing, ye kya represent kar raha hai? Let us try to see. Okay, so it is representing something like this. Epsilon plus A plus AB plus double A plus double AB plus ABA plus AB AB plus, again here you can open this one, aap isko bhi open kar sakte hain. After opening this, what I will get triple A plus I will get A A A B plus I will get A A B A plus I will get double A B A B and so on, right? So that means here no two B's are coming together. Yahan par koi bhi do B jo hai wo ek saath nahi aa rahe, correct? No two B's are coming together. So we can have two A's, right? We can have single zero A's, we can have one A, we can have two A's, we can have three A's also, we can have four A's also. So the A's can come together, but you will see no two B's are coming together. Koi bhi do B ek saath nahi aa rahe hain. Okay. So here only one B is there, here only one B is there. Here we have two B's, but these two B's will never come together. Right? Here you can see these two B's will never come together. No two B's will come together in this case. So you can identify the language based on this. I will take a lot more examples here. Kafi examples honge. I will take a lot of these, all of these examples. You will understand it one by one. You will understand it clearly. Aap isko kafi clearly aur acche se samajh payenge. Okay, let me take a few more examples.
सो आई थिंक वी हैव ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड डी एफ ए फॉर दिस. आपने इसके लिए डी एफ ए भी बनाया था. आई हैव ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड डी एफ ए फॉर दिस. अंकित आई विल रिप्लाई टू योर क्वेश्चन इन सम टाइम. जस्ट गिव मी सम टाइम, आई रिप्लाई टू योर क्वेश्चन. ओके एंड सो बिकॉज इन योर क्वेश्चन आई डोंट नो व्हाई यू सेंड दिस कैप सिंबल. सो यू कैन हैव ए डबल बी, आई मीन टू स्टार्स कैन बी देयर, बट देर इज नो कैप सिंबल हियर. लाइक यू हैव यूज्ड दिस सिंबल इन योर क्वेश्चन अंकित, एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट वी हैव ओनली थ्री ऑपरेशंस हियर. वी हैव द फर्स्ट ऑपरेशन इज यूनियन, सेकेंड इज कॉन्कैटनेशन, एंड थर्ड इज क्लेम क्लोजर. एंड दिस इज नॉट एन ऑपरेशन विच इज स्पेसिफाइड हियर. सो प्लीज करेक्ट योर क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, फाइन. सो हियर आई थिंक वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन द डी एफ ए फॉर दिस एग्जाम्पल. इसके लिए हमने डी एफ ए भी देखा था. वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन द डी एफ ए. वट वॉज द डी एफ ए इफ यू रिमेंबर इट क्लियरली, अगर आपको याद हो वट वॉज द डी एफ ए. सो इट रिप्रेजेंट्स स्ट्रिंग्स विच आर स्टार्टिंग विद ए, देन ओनली बी शुड बी देयर, देन ओनली सी शुड बी देयर. सो दिस लैंग्वेज इज अ रेगुलर लैंग्वेज. वाई? बिकॉज वी कैन क्रिएट अ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा फॉर दिस, राइट? तो ये जो लैंग्वेज है, just hold on a second, I think I'm getting a call again and again. So yeah, so this language is representing your regular language. ये जो लैंग्वेज है ये रेगुलर लैंग्वेज को रिप्रेजेंट कर रही है. दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ रेगुलर लैंग्वेज. एंड व्हाई इट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ रेगुलर लैंग्वेज? बिकॉज यू कैन मेक अ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा फॉर दिस, राइट? आई कैन मेक अ डी एफ ए, आई कैन मेक अ एन एफ ए ऑल्सो. सो लेट मी मेक बोथ ऑफ देम. So I can make a DFA, that is deterministic finite automata. First of all, let me make an NFA here instead of DFA. I can make an NFA. I can also make a DFA, right? So because if NFA is there, obviously DFA will also be there, right? So I told you that what is the significance of NFA also. We have already covered that in our classes in a lot of depth. Now in this language number 8, in case of an NFA, you can make it something like this. Initially, you are present at the state Q0, and here number of n should be greater than or equal to 1. Number of n jo hai wo greater than or equal to 1 hona chahiye. So initially you are present at the state q0. If you get a single a, you will go to the state q1, and here any number of a's can be there. Then if you get a b, you will go to the state q2, and here any number of b's can be there. If you get a c, you will go to the state q3, which is representing a final state, and here any number of c can be there. Right? This is presenting your NFA. In the same way, we have also seen a DFA for this. आपने इसके लिए DFA भी देखा था. So DFA looked something like this. Initially, this is the state Q0. In the beginning, if I get a symbol B or if I get a symbol C, I will go to the state, let us suppose D, which represents a dead state, right? So that means it is also, it can represent a trap state. ये एक trap state को represent करे. This is presenting a trap state. And if I get an A, I will go to the state Q1, and here we can have any number of A's. But in this state, if I get a C, I will go to this trap state. Here, if I get a B, I will go to the state Q2. And in this case, we can have any number of B's. But if I get a C, I mean, if I get an A, then I will go here. And again, if I get a C, I will go to the state Q3, which is the final state. We can have any number of C's here. But in this state, if you get a B or if you get a A, then I'm going to this trap state here, right? So हम लोग उस केस में trap state पर जाएंगे. So this one is representing your deterministic finite automata. तो ये जो है ये deterministic finite automata को represent कर रहा है. Okay? It is representing a deterministic finite automata. So obviously, because you can make a DFA here, because आप यहाँ पर एक DFA बना सकते हैं, so that is why we can say this language is a regular language. यहाँ पर आप finite automata बना सकते हैं. You can make a finite automata for this. So I can clearly say that this language is a regular language. So obviously, because this language is a regular language, therefore I can use a regular expression to represent this. तो यहाँ पर जो है मैं इसको रिप्रेजेंट करने के लिए रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन का यूज कर सकता हूँ. सो द रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन लुक समथिंग लाइक दिस. आई कैन राइट इट एज ए प्लस डॉट बी प्लस डॉट सी प्लस, विच इज एक्चुअली इक्विवेलेंट टू सेइंग ए डॉट ए स्टार, बी डॉट बी स्टार, एज वेल एज सी डॉट सी स्टार. And if you match it with the diagram, you'll see a correlation. अगर आप इसको डायग्राम से मैच करेंगे, you will find there's a correlation here. What is that correlation? So here, this is the A. So this A is represented like this, right? Let me rub this one. बीच में जो मैंने यहाँ पर DFA बनाया है, let me rub the DFA so that I can use this space to explain you a lot more things, my dear friends. Right? So you guys are my superstar, super duper heroes, my idols, right? So then you can see that I'm using this self loop. I'm using this star to represent the self loop. Okay? I'm using this B. So this B is exactly here. I'm using this self loop. So this self loop is represented by the star. I'm using this C and it is represented by the C here. And I'm using this self loop. So this self loop is represented by the star here. Okay? इतना क्लियर है सभी के साथ? इज इट क्लियर विद एवरीवन सो फार? एनी डाउट्स? सो अंकित विड नेवर यूज बी रेस्ट पावर स्टार ए. तो हम लोग ऐसा नहीं करते हैं. आई थिंक ओके. सो यू आर सेइंग आई अंडरस्टूड योर क्वेश्चन, व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू से. सो आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम अंकित. आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम अंकित एंड अंकित इज सेइंग दैट वी हैव अ लैंग्वेज विच इज ए बी स्टार ए. दिस इज योर क्वेश्चन, राइट? ए बी स्टार ए. Fine, so you are asking what it is representing. I think this is one of the easiest question I've already solved this one. Ye main already solve kar chuka hun. This is one of the easiest question here. So this is just representing this B can represent it by string of length 0, which is again double A, right? Okay. Oh, I think I've done a little mistake in the previous question. Maybe I can correct this, that one also. And here we can have A, B, A. Here we can have A double B A, we can have A triple B A, and so on, right? So let me correct my previous mistake. I think I've done a mistake. I just realized that I done a mistake here. What is the mistake? So here they are saying string starting and ending with A in any combination of B in between. Right, so that means in this language L7, we will have the strings which are single A, we can have double A, we can have A B A, we can have A double B A, we can have A triple B A, and so on. Correct? Now, what was my mistake? I can write this A as it is, right? But all of this part here, ye jitna bhi part hai, all of this part here. Is representing A B star A. It is representing A B star A. ठीक है? All of this part is representing A B star A. So this is representing the regular expression for this problem. Clear है? Is it clear with everyone? Understood? What was my mistake? Good. So sometimes I make silly mistakes because I have to take care of a lot of different things. Right? It happens. Lot of time with me. So what I have to do here is, let me tell you a brief idea. So right now when I'm teaching, I have to read charts here on this system. I also have to read charts on this system. So I have two systems which are paralleling working, right? So here approximately 22 people are there and here approximately 15 people are there. So I have to read chart on both the systems, right? So that is why what happens is I tend to make mistake because my mind is, you know, working a lot of places. Here also I'm working, here also I'm working, here also I'm working. At the same time I might be thinking about something else. So that is why I tend to make a lot of mistakes during the classes. It happens, right? Okay, so let us see the next one. All the strings which begins or end with either 00 or 11, right? So 00 hai or 11 hai. So in this case we have the string which is 00 and 11, that means, so either we can have a string which will start with 00, in between we can have any combination of 0 and 1, and it can also end with 00, right? Or the strings might start with 00, in between you can have any combination of 0 and 1, in the end we can have 11. Or we can have a string which starts with 11, in between we can have any combination of A and B, it will end with 11.
or we can have a string which will start with double one. It will have any combination of A and B, and it will end with double zero. Okay. Now in this case, from this first part, I can take this as common. Here also, I can take this as common. So ye jo part hai, this is common in both of them. In the same way, here I can take this as well as I can also take this. So these things I can take as a common. So this one can be represented by double zero, zero plus one star, and here we have double zero plus double one, right? Plus we can have double one a, so this is zero plus one, not a plus b. So I tend to make mistakes a lot of time. Like this is a very, very silly mistake. Again, I'm not sure why I do such things. Maybe I should see a doctor sometime. I make such silly mistakes all the time, right? So zero plus one, so zero plus one. I'm a mental patient. I'm thinking like this. Okay. So I make a lot of mistakes like this, right? Now let us see this one. So here again, I can take zero plus one star, and then again we can have zero zero plus one one. Okay. So again from this, I can take this zero zero plus one one as common. राइट यहाँ से हम लोग इसको भी कॉमन ले सकते हैं. दैट मीन्स आई विल बी हैविंग जीरो 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 प्लस वन स्टार प्लस वन वन जीरो प्लस वन स्टार एंड इन द एंड वी आर गोइंग टू हैव डबल जीरो प्लस डबल वन. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस अगेन आई कैन टेक जीरो प्लस वन स्टार इज कॉमन. सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, व्हाट विल आई गेट? आई विल गेट डबल जीरो प्लस डबल वन. एंड हियर इफ आई टेक जीरो प्लस वन स्टार, माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, then I will be having 0, 0 plus 1, 1 here, and this is representing the regular expression for this problem. So ye jo hai, yahan par regular expression ki tarah represent kar raha hai. I hope it is clear. Aap sabhi ke sath clear hoga. To ye laga BSNL chakka, connecting India. All strings which begins or ends with either 0, 0 or 1, 1. Yes, again, same mistake. Yes, so this is solution is again, here this solution is for the symbol AND. It is not for OR. So again, this is the same thing which happened. So jo solution maine kiya hai, this solution is for AND. So I was just checking if you guys are also noticing this. Aapne notice kiya, and that is very, very good. And so this is actually not my mistake. I kind of planned it. तो ये मेरी मिस्टेक नहीं है. दिस इज समथिंग आई प्लान. आई वॉन्टेड टू नो दैट इफ यू गाइज आर फोकसिंग देन डेफिनेटली यू विल आस्क दिस. एंड बिकॉज ओनली वन पर्सन नोफला आस्क, सो दैट मीन्स आई नो दैट ओनली वन पर्सन इज फोकसिंग, अदर्स आर नॉट. ठीक है, तो लेट मी करेक्ट इट. ठीक है, सो दिस प्रॉब्लम इज बेसिकली टू पार्ट प्रॉब्लम. आई कैन मेक टू डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस हियर. इन दिस लैंग्वेज 10, आई कैन यूज एन एंड सिंबल. In this first language, I'm using an OR symbol. Okay? I'm using an OR symbol. So what is this language? It says all the strings which begins or ends with either 00 or 01. Ya to wo 00 se start ho, ya fir wo 01 se. Ya to 00 start ho, 011 se start ho, ya fir 00 se end ho, ya fir 11 se end ho. This is something that I wanted. Okay, so that means we can have a string which starts with 0, 0, and then we can have any combination of 0 and 1. Or we can have a string which starts with 1, 1, and then we can have any combination of 0 and 1. Or we can have a string which ends with 0, 0. Or we can have a string which ends with 1, 1. Right, ab theek hai? Is it correct now? Have I written it correctly? Please answer. क्या मैंने अब ठीक किया है? Have I written it correctly, my dear friends? Answer me in the chat window. क्या मैंने अब ठीक किया है? Yes, so you guys are saying कि हमने ठीक किया. Yes, we have done it correctly. So that means I can take this one as common here. So this will be 00 plus 11. Then I will take 0 plus 1 as common here. And here again, I can take 0 plus 1 as common. And here I will get 00 plus 11. And now it is perfect. What a beautiful solution.
What a beautiful solution, man. That's such a beautiful sixer, right? So what a beautiful solution connecting India. Great. So now you understood what is the difference between AND and OR, and you understood a lot of things here. Please answer this question. Please write the regular expression for this problem in the chat window. Is question ke liye regular expression sabhi chat window ke andar likhenge. Please write the regular expressions in the chat window. Third character from the right end of the string is always A. String ke right hand se third character hamesha A hona chahiye. So what is the strings? What are the strings which are present in this language? We can have this language L9. So what are the strings which are present in this language? Okay. So let us assume that the length of the string is always greater than equal to 3. Right? So hum log isko imagine karenge ki jo language hai wo hamesha 3 se zyada uski length ho. So I can say here the length of the string is always greater than or equal to 3. Ye hamesha greater than or equal to 3 rahegi. Fine. Good. Now let us see this one. So that means if I take any string here, so third character from the right hand side, right? So for example here, I think Sachin, your answer is different, right? So Sachin, you're not giving third character from the right hand side. So here that means if I take B A A B, correct? So this is representing the left hand side and this is representing your right hand side. So I want it from the right hand side. If I go in this direction, then third character from the right hand side should be A. So yahan par jo hai third character wo A hona chahiye. This is what I want. So a lot of different strings are possible here. A lot of different strings are possible. So this language is basically infinite language. So I can also make a DFA for this. Obviously, this is one of the problems that you must have done during, you know, the problems, I think, during the finite automata. So let me create an NFA here. Let me create an NFA. It says that initially we are present at the state Q0. In the beginning, we can have any combinations of A and B. Then we can get an A. This A is representing the third character from the right hand side, right? Then I will go to the state Q1. Here I can have A or B. I will go to the state Q2. Again, we can have A or B. I will go to the state Q3, and this is our final state. So this is presenting an NFA for this problem, right? Ye aapka NFA ko represent kar raha hai, or you can say this is presenting just your finite automata. Ye aapke finite automata ko represent kar raha hai. Fine. And we have already done this problem. Like this problem is like, sir, this problem is like bachcho ka khel, and I want some difficult problems, right? You guys are like this. Right, aap mujhse is tarah ke question puchhenge, my guide might be asking, sir, this problem is just like bachcho ka khel, sir. Sir, why are you joking with us, sir? Why is this is such an easy problem, sir? Why are you giving us such an easy problem? I'll say, calm down, beta. I'll give you difficult problems, and you will say, ki, sir, aapne kya kar diya, right? So let us understand this. Let us go through with it, okay? So here, the RA will look something like this. In the beginning, we can have any combination of A and B. हमारे पास A और B का कोई भी combination हो सकता है. We can have any combination of A and B. So that means I'm representing this loop using this A plus B whole star. मैं इस loop को A plus B whole star से represent कर रहा हूँ. We can have any combination of A and B. Fine. After this, then this A is there. So I'm going to concatenate here. I'm going to use this A. Then again concatenation operation, and then we have A comma B. So here A comma B will be represented by A plus B. Again, I'm going to use a concatenation. Again, I'm going to represent this A comma B with A plus B. So this is representing your final regular expression, sir. Sir, this is representing your final regular expressions, and I hope that you understood this one. Aapko samajh mein aaya hoga. Any doubt so far? Yes, Nofla, lot of problems are there, right? So our life is a problem. Solve life problems, you'll get this problem, okay? Leave these problems on me, you can solve your life problems, okay? Right? It was easy. Easy tha. It was very easy. So it was such an easy problem. It was such an easy question. Now answer this question. I want answers from all of you. Aap sabhi se answer chahiye. The question is, all strings having at least two B's over summation is equal to ABC. We have three symbols here, which is A, B, and C. I want all strings where we should have at least two B's. We can have more than two B's also, but at least two B's should be there. Do B ho sakte hain, but we can have more than two B's also. Please write the answer in the chat window. Kajol, your answer is also not correct. Your answer is also wrong. Nidhi, your answer is wrong. Sachin, your answer is wrong. Mera life se vishwas chut jayega. I'll commit suicide after this because of your answers. Yes, Snowfly, your answer is now right. Finally, I've got a right answer. What is the correct answer, my dear friends? What is the correct answer? Sir, what is the correct answer, sir? So, in the beginning, we can have any combination of A, B, and C. Then, one B can be there. After this, again, we can have any combination of A, B, and C. Again, one B can be there. After this, again, we can have any combination of A, B, and C. And again, it is star. Okay? So, this is the regular expression for this problem. They are saying at least two B's can be there. Right? So, yahan par at least two B ho sakte hain. At least two B's. Yes, ma'am. Kajol, ma'am. You are right. But Kajol, ma'am, I think your question was, your answer was a little wrong. Maybe somewhere it was wrong. So maybe you can check it again. Okay. Great. Great. You guys are duper, super duper stars. Good. Priyanka, where you are facing the problem in this? Because this was very easy, right? So let me explain this one again. Neerja, your answer is again wrong. Aapka answer bhi wrong hai. Let me explain this again. Right? So we have two kinds of problem here. So if you read this problem and the previous problem, here in this problem we are having at least word. Yahan par humare paas at least word hai. And then in the second problem, we have the word exactly. So you have two problems here. One is having at least word and second one is having exactly word. That's it, right? Okay. So this is exactly, and the first one was having the word at least. Okay. And here over the summation is equal to A comma B. So when I done this problem at least, jab maine is question ko at least mein kiya tha, at least means we have A plus B plus C whole star. In the beginning, we can have any combination of A, B and C. Then one B can come, and between these two B's, we can have any combination of A, B and C. Again, one B can come. And after this, we can have any combination of A, B and C, right? So most of you have used star with B. Yahan par B ke saath koi bhi star nahi aayega. Okay? Why we need to put three times? Maybe I can make a DFA for this. Maybe I can make a FA for this and then I can make you explain this, right? So when I'm using this at least, so how will my finite automata look like? So this is the initial state, which is Q naught. In the state Q naught, we can have any combination of A, B and C. And then one B can be there. I will go to the state Q1. Again, we can have any combination of A, B and C. Again, one B can be there. Again, we go to the state Q3. And here also any combination of A, B and C can come, right? So this was in the case where we were having the word at least. Yani kam se kam aapke paas two times b aana chahiye, do se zyada bhi ho sakta hai. We can have more than two also, but kam se kam aapke paas do bar b aana chahiye, right? But when I use the word exactly, when I use the word exactly, ki aapke paas exactly do b ho sakte hain, we cannot have more than two b's. So that means your FA will look something like this. Aapka jo FA hai wo kuch aisa dikhega. This is initial state, that is Q naught. Here we can have any combination of A and C. Yahan par A aur C ka koi bhi combination ho sakta hai. We cannot have B. A and C, any combination of A and C. Here I'm having one B. I will go to the state Q1. Again, we can have any combination of A and C. Again, I will have one B. I will go to the state Q2, which is the final state. Again, we can have any combination of A and C. Here, these B's, jo aapke paas beech mein B hai, so we should have exactly two. So yahan par exactly do hone chahiye, right? So if I write a regular expression for this, what will this regular expression represent? how will I write this regular expression?
So because of this loop, I can write A plus C star. Then I have this B. Then I can write A plus C star. Then I can write this B, and again I can write A plus C star. Right, so what is the difference between both of them?
Yahan par dono mein difference kya hai?
So in this case, here we can have any number of B's, right? They are saying at least two B's, but more than two B can also be there.
And here in the second example, they are saying exactly two B, we cannot have more than two B's. Clear sabhi ke saath? Is it clear with everyone? Right? So this is the correct regular expression for this. Yes, ki correct regular expression hai. Neerja, your answer is wrong. Priyanka, have you understood this one so far? Kya aapko samajh mein aaya? Have you understood the answer? Yes, Ananya, your answer is right. You are absolutely correct. Nidhi, clear. Good, good, good. So it is clear with all of you. So that is why sometimes I say you guys are superheroes, superhuman beings. Now look at this one. So again, this is the question which is based on at least. Question dobara se aapke paas at least ke upar based hai. Read the question once again, then maybe you can write the answer in the chat window. All strings should have at least one zero and at least one one. आपके पास कम से कम एक जीरो होना चाहिए और कम से कम एक वन होना चाहिए, उसके बाद कुछ भी हो सकता है. नो रेल, नो प्रियंका, क्रिएटिंग रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशंस इज नॉट सच अ डिफिकल्ट प्रॉब्लम. राइट, दिस क्रिएटिंग रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन इज इजियर एज कंपेयर टू क्रिएटिंग डीएफए. आई थिंक क्रिएटिंग अ फाइनल ऑटोमेटा, क्रिएटिंग अ रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन, बोथ ऑफ देम आर लाइक इक्वल इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिफिकल्टी. If you can create a finite automata, then directly you can also create a regular expression. It is not the case that regular expressions are more difficult. These are actually easy. Regular expressions aapki easy hai. It is not such a difficult problem, right? So what you can do here is you can maybe you can do more practice. You can solve, if by solving some previous questions, you will be able to solve it very easily, right? So aisa kuch difficulty nahi aayegi. Maybe because you are studying the topic for the first time, that is why you are facing the problem. But after a few lectures, after solving a few previous year questions, you will be able to solve it very easily. It will be like a cakewalk for you. Okay? So these topics, all these topics are easy topics here. Okay? So I've got one answer from Chetana. I need answers from all of you. Please write your answers in the chat window. I think I've not received any correct answer so far. Chetra, your answer is wrong. Shubham, your answer is wrong. Abhay, your answer is wrong. Ananya, your answer is wrong. Nofla, answer is wrong. Nidhi, answer is wrong. Priyanka, your answer is also wrong. And Mansa, your answer is also wrong. Aap sabhi ke jo answers hain, ye sabhi galat hain. None of you have given me a correct answer here. Aap sabhi mein se kisi ka bhi answer correct nahi hai. Sachin, your answer is also wrong. You are following a right path, but your answer is still wrong. So let me explain here. First of all, before solving, let us first of all understand what are the strings that can be there. Isme kya kya string ho sakti hai? What are the strings that can be present in this language, my dear friends? Kaun kaun si strings ho sakti hai? So we can have a string which is 0, 1. So here at least 1, 0 is there and 1, 1 is there. तो आपके पास एक स्ट्रिंग है यहां पर 01, as well as we can also have a string 10, and all of you actually missed this string. आप सभी ने इस स्ट्रिंग को मिस कर दिया. All of you understood this one. आप सभी ने इस पार्ट को तो सॉल्व कर दिया, but you have missed this part, because the string can also start with 1. Instead of starting with 0, the string can also start with 1, right? So we can also have a string which is 0 0 1, which is 0 1 0, which is 0 1 1. We can also have 0, or I can say in this manner, we can have 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0, right? And so on. Okay, right? So if you look at all the strings that can be there, then we can have 0 plus 1 star 0
again 0 plus 1 star 1, again 0 plus 1 star plus, we can have 0 plus 1 star 1, 0 plus 1 star 0, and 0 plus 1 star 0. So I hope that you understood this part. I hope aapko samajh mein aaya hoga. What is the problem that you did? What is wrong in your solution? What was wrong in your solution? The thing that was wrong is this. Jo wrong tha wo ye tha that here we have 0 and 1. And here we have 1 and 0. So these are two different parts of solution. And after this, here in 0 and 1, we do not have a star. And then I can take something as common. Maybe I can take this as common. Or maybe I can take this as common. So that you can minimize this RE. आप इसको मिनिमाइज भी कर सकते हैं राइट एंड हियर कौशल्या देवी योर आंसर इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग लेट अस टेक द नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इवन लेंथ स्ट्रिंग्स माई डियर फ्रेंड्स नाउ वी कम अप विद अ वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग शुड बी इवन अगर आपके पास इवन लेंथ स्ट्रिंग होगा देन वट विल हैपन इफ वी हैव स्ट्रिंग्स ऑफ इवन लेंथ ठीक है लेट मी अगेन आई थिंक इफ आई एम नॉट डन एनी प्रॉब्लम आई मीन इफ आई हैव डन सॉल्व द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन करेक्टली राइट शुड हैव एटलीस्ट 1 0 एंड एटलीस्ट हाँ आई थिंक आई हैव सॉल्व इट करेक्टली तो नेक्स्ट वन इवन लेंथ स्ट्रिंग राइट सो इफ यू लुक एट दिस वन इफ यू लुक एट दिस वन व्हाट विल बी द योर फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा फॉर दिस सो हियर द इनपुट सिंबल्स आर 0 एंड 1 आपके इनपुट सिंबल 0 और 1 है करेक्ट सो इफ यू क्रिएट अ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा हियर Then in that case, initial this state is there, which is representing Q naught. As soon as we get a 0 or 1, we go to the state Q1. Again, if we get a 0 or 1, we go to the state Q naught. Okay. And you already know whenever I write 0 and 1, then I represent it as 0 plus 1. Therefore, I'm also going to represent this as 0 plus 1. And secondly, if I have a state in middle, so that will be represented by a concatenation symbol. And then if I have a loop is represented by a clean closure. Okay, loop was represented by a clean closure. Therefore, this can also be represented in this manner, which is 0 plus 1 dot 0 plus 1, right? So this is 0 plus 1, this is dot, this is 0 plus 1. And because this everything is in a loop, so this is star. It is representing strings of even length. Clear? So what I've done here, I've taken string of length 1, concatenated with string of length 1. And because when I say string, even length string, that means it is 2 raised to the power 0 plus 2 raised to the power 1, 2 raised to the power 2, 2 raised to the power 3, and so on, right? So here, this is 2. And then because of this star, I've taken raised to power. So if I just ask you one more thing here, this was about even length. If I just change this even by odd somehow, agar main is even ko odd mein convert kar, then what will be the answer? So odd means, dekho, when I'm writing even, so even means it is 2 into n, right? And when I'm writing odd, odd means it is 2 into n plus 1. In the previous case, when I have written 2 raised to power 0 and 2 raised to power 1, it does not mean that I'm writing 4 here. 2 raised to power 2 does not mean 4. So this power meant what is the length? Power ka matlab kya tha? Length. Right? So we can have string of length 2, we can have string of length 4, we can have string of length 6, we can have string of length 8, and so on. So when I write it 2 raised to power 3, it means I wanted to say that it's string of length 6. So do not confuse it with powers, right? उसको उस तरीके से confuse मत करना, because then it will become exponential that I do not want you to get confused with, right? तो मैं आपको confusion नहीं चाहता था उस केस में. Okay, so look at this one here. When I'm saying that we have a length even, that means it is 2 into n. And when I'm saying we want to have a length odd, that means 2 into n plus 1, right? So here in both of these cases, n can be 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on till infinity. So when I take this language L3, here, सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग ऑड लेंथ स्ट्रिंग्स, यानी कि जिनकी भी लेंथ ऑड है हमें वो लेना है. सो आई हैव टू टेक अ स्ट्रिंग ऑफ इवन लेंथ एंड देन आई हैव टू ऐड वन टू इट. मुझे इवन लेंथ की स्ट्रिंग को लेना है, उसमें वन को ऐड करना है. सो इन द प्रीवियस एग्जाम्पल, दैट इज एग्जाम्पल नंबर L12, वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इवन. सो व्हाट वाज द सॉल्यूशन? टेक अ स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 1. सो हियर वी हैव 0, 1, यहाँ पर सिंबल 0, 1 है. सो टेक अ स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 1, अगेन टेक अ स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 1. सो दिस बिकेम द लेंथ 2. ये बन गया आपके पास लेंथ 2. एंड देन यू हैव टू टेक अ पावर हियर, सो यू हैव टू डू अ स्टार विच इज क्लेम क्लोजर. सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग स्ट्रिंग ऑफ इवन लेंथ. सो वेन आई नीड स्ट्रिंग ऑफ ऑड लेंथ, दैट मीन्स आई एम गोइंग टू कंकैटिनेट स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ 1 विद इट. सो माई सॉल्यूशन विल बी 0+1.0+1 होल स्टार डॉट 0+1. सो दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग स्ट्रिंग ऑफ ऑड लेंथ. ये आपकी ऑड लेंथ की स्ट्रिंग को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है. क्लियर? आई होप इट इज क्लियर. एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई से दैट यू गाइस आर सुपर डुपर स्मार्ट, बिकॉज यू अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग इन वन गो. एंड आई डो नॉट हैव टू डू लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट विद यू. आप सभी बहुत अच्छे से सब कुछ समझ पाते हैं. नेक्स्ट, नंबर ऑफ एज आर डिविजिबल बाई 3. जितने भी ए हैं वो 3 से डिविजिबल होने चाहिए. सो इफ यू रिमेंबर वॉट इज अ फाइनाइट ऑटोमेटा फॉर दिस, और राइट आई कैन मेक अ NFA, राइट? NFA इज ईजियर टू मेक. सो आई कैन मेक इट इन दिस मैनर. इनिशियल स्टेट वी हैव क्यू नॉट. सो वी कैन हैव एज आर डिविजिबल बाई 3. वी आर नॉट काउंटिंग द नंबर ऑफ बीज एट ऑल. हम नंबर ऑफ बी को काउंट नहीं कर रहे. ओके, मिंगमा आई डू नॉट टेक एनी क्लासेज ऑन अन अकेडमी. सो आई हैव माई ओन क्लासेज. आई डू नॉट टेक एनी क्लासेज बट सो एवर ऑन अन अकेडमी प्लीज. सो आई डू नॉट गेट माई सेल्फ अटैच्ड विद देम. सच अ सिली क्वेश्चन. जी जी, चलो एनी वेज लेट अस डू दिस. सो हियर वी हैव क्यू नॉट एंड हियर वी कैन हैव एनी कॉम्बिनेशन. सो बिकॉज देर आर टू सिंबल्स विच इज 0 and 1, राइट? So here, I think, okay, so there's a problem here, but it's a fundamental problem with the problem and with the fundamental issue with the problem here, that this symbol is given is wrong. So here summation should be equal to a comma b. Instead of 0, 1, it is a comma b. Okay? Now let me solve it. So how can you make a FA? Aap iske liye FA kaise bana sakte? How can you make a FA? So this is your initial state Q naught. In the beginning, we can have any number of b's because we are not really caring about number of b's. We are just caring about the number of a's. So if I get a single a, I will go to the state Q1 and here we can have any number of b's. Again, if I get a single a, I will go to the state Q3. Again, we can have any number of b's. Again, if I get one more a, I will go back to the state Q0. Now, which will be your final state? In sabhi mein se kaun si state final hogi? Right, which will be your final state? This Q0 will be your final state because the string of length 0 is also allowed. यहाँ पर जो strings जिनकी length 0 है वो भी allowed है. Okay, so this will be your final state. So if you look at this diagram, then making the regular expression becomes easier for you guys, right? Because you understand that whenever I am taking this self loop, I am taking this self loop, I'm taking this self loop, so I can represent all of these self loop using star. So I can represent this with B star. Here I can represent this with B star. Here I can represent this with B star. So in sabhi self loop ko hum star se represent kar sakte hain. I can represent all of these self loops using star. And then here I'm having all of these A's in the concatenation. So sabhi jo A hai, wo concatenation mein hai. Right? So we can have A here. We can have an A here, we can have a A here. Correct? Itna clear hai sabhi ke saath? Fine. But there's two issues here, right? So again, you can solve in this manner also, but I can just for safety purpose, because I have to calculate in that manner also, I'm just adding star. Right? So that means you can also have a string which is A, B, A, B, A, B. So here the number of A's are 3. Right? So again, see, even if I do not add that, still I can give you a right solution. I can still give you a correct solution. But just to make things easier for you, I'm just adding it. Maybe I can also show you that without adding this one also, I can get a right answer. Okay. So, because this everything is in a loop, my dear friends, because this everything is in a loop, so I have to take this as a star. So this is representing all the strings where the number of A's are divisible by 3. यहाँ पर जितने भी A हैं वो 3 से divisible है. So we can have 0A, 1A, 2A, 3A and so on. And I'm also going to concatenate B here. I mean, I'm also going to take a union of B, right? That means we can also have only B's, right? Therefore, what I wanted to say here, that only B is also accepted. ठीक है? यानि कि अगर आपका string है only B, or we can have epsilon. So epsilon is also present in the language because number of A's are zero. Single B is also present in the language because number of A's are zero. Double B is also present. Triple B is also present. Four times B is also present, right? And so on. Right, so we can have any number of B's because number of A's are zero. Then we can have three A's. We can have three A's like this. We can have B triple A. We can have A B A A. We can have A A B A. We can have A A A B, right? And then we can have two B's also. You can also have like this, B A B A A. You can also have A double B A A and so on like this, right? So I have to handle all of these cases. मुझे ये सभी cases को handle करना है. Fine. Now the problem that you guys are having, you are asking, sir, I have a huge problem with this diagram, sir. I'm asking, yes, dear, what is your problem? What is the issue? I'm asking your issue. Now you're saying, sir, why have you used this? Why you added this B star, sir? Why you just added this B star when you have used all of these B's from there? Now my answer here is, buddy, so far, I have two answers, right? Actually, not one answer, I have two answers. First, so far, I haven't told you how to convert a finite automata to RE. I'm just representing a correlation between them. Kaise convert karna hai, I've not covered so far. That I will be covering in this lecture, obviously. Theek hai? So I'm just showing a kind of a correlation. That is, what is the correlation of finite automata with your regular expression? This is the first answer. Right? Second answer is, here this state Q naught is also an initial state and it is also a final state. Q naught jo hai wo initial state bhi hai aur ye final state bhi hai, and as well as it is also accepting B, right? So that means if I do not really have this entire diagram, if I only have this, that means it is representing B star alone. ये सिर्फ B star को भी represent कर रहा है. So that we will be answering, right? So that we will be answering in this upcoming sessions, how to convert this DFA or finite automata to regular expressions. That we'll be covering in the upcoming lectures, in upcoming sessions also. Don't worry about it. I will take everything from the basics. You will understand this step by step. ठीक है, वी आर जस्ट गोइंग स्टेप बाय स्टेप. मे बी आई कैन टेक मोर एग्जांपल्स, यू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, ओके डियर मिंगमा भुटिया, सो डोंट वरी. सो आई थिंक यू हैव माय कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर, और यू कैन फाइंड माय कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर फ्रॉम द चैनल ऑल्सो. यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट मी लेटर ऑन, वी कैन हैव अ कॉन्वर्जेशन. ठीक है, डोंट वरी. Okay, fine. Let me take another example from here. Now you have to tell me, what is the language denoted by this? Yahan se kya language aayegi? What will be the language denoted by this? So the language will be, here you can see, first of all, this entire is in star. Okay, pura jo hai yahan par. So this entire, we are using a plain closure. So that means obviously we can also have string of length 0. आपके पास स्ट्रिंग ऑफ लेंथ जीरो भी हो सकती है, दैट इज एप्सिलॉन. नाउ व्हाट इफ आई रिप्लेस दिस स्टार विद वन, राइट? सो दैट मींस वी कैन से, ओके, लेट मी डू इट स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो वी कैन हैव बी स्टार डबल ए, आई मीन ट्रिपल ए स्टार, बी स्टार होल रेस्ट पावर जीरो, प्लस वी कैन ऑल्सो हैव बी स्टार ट्रिपल ए डबल स्टार b star whole raised to power 1 plus, we can also have b star triple a b star whole raised to power 2 and so on, like this, something like this is there. Okay, now in this case this entire is representing epsilon and this entire is representing b star triple a star b star plus all of the other parts. So let us understand this part only. Is part ko samajhne ki koshish karte, let us try to understand this part. So this part is saying in the beginning we can have any number of b's, right? We can have 0b, 1b, 2b, 3b, 4b, 5b, 6b, 7b, 8b and so on. In the end also we can have any number of b. We can have 1b, 2b, 3b, 4b, 5b, 6b, 7b, 8b and so on. We can have any number of b's. But in this middle portion, all the a's should be in the multiple of 3. We can have 3a, we can have 0a, we can have 3a, we can have 6a, we can have 9a, we can have 12a and so on, right? So all of these a's should be contiguous as well as they should be in the multiple of 3, right? Again, the same thing will repeat in the other cases. So in this manner, you can describe what is the language represented by this. Okay? Next. So again, I'll demonstrate this example in more details. Right now, just giving a brief idea regarding this. I will demonstrate this example in more details in some time because a lot of examples are there to cover. Then I'll also demonstrate that example. Next. All strings that do not contain the substring AB. Yani ki hamare paas AB substring nahi hona chahiye. All strings that do not contain the substring AB. Can you give a regular expression for this? Kya aap yahan par regular expression de sakte hain iske liye? We do not want a substring as AB. I want answers from all of you, so please write your answers in the chat window. Shubham, your answer is kind of, your answer is not covering, I mean it is wrong because it is not covering every string here, every damn possible string it is not covering. I do not want AB as a substring. Mujhe AB substring mein nahi chahiye. I do not want AB as a substring. So in Mansa, in your answer, we are getting AB as a substring. Yahan par AB aapke paas aa raha hai as a substring. Any other answer here? Because we have covered a lot of topics so far. At least one of you should give me a correct answer. So let me give a brief idea here. Right? I think none of you given me correct answer. Maybe Sachin, you are not covering all the possible cases. Aapne sabhi possible cases cover nahi kiya hai. Correct? So, okay, let me tell you two ways, right? So obviously you are finding the problem difficult, correct? We all understand that sometimes the question becomes difficult. Like for example, for me, this question is easy, right? I can easily solve it. But for some of you guys, this question is difficult. आप में से कुछ ऐसे लोग होंगे जिसके लिए ये क्वेश्चन जो है वो डिफिकल्ट है. फॉर सम ऑफ यू गाइस दिस इज लिटिल ट्रिकी वन, लिटिल डिफिकल्ट वन. व्हाट टू डू देन वी गेट अ ट्रिकी क्वेश्चंस, व्हाट टू डू व्हेन वी गेट अ डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन. देन व्हाट आई कैन डू इज आई कैन मेक अ डीएफए एंड आई कैन कन्वर्ट दिस डीएफए टू अ रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन. मैं उस डीएफए को रेगुलर एक्सप्रेशन में कन्वर्ट कर सकता हूँ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल हियर आई कैन मेक अ डीएफए, राइट? तो यहाँ पर जो है मैं एक DFA बना सकता हूँ फॉर दिस गिवन लैंग्वेज, राइट? ए बी सबस्ट्रिंग शुड नॉट बी देयर. सो व्हाट विल बी दैट DFA? इनिशियली आई एम प्रेजेंट एट द स्टेट क्यू नॉट, राइट? सो इन द स्टेट क्यू नॉट द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग इज जीरो एंड ऑब्वियसली इन द लेंथ स्ट्रिंग जीरो ए बी इज नॉट देयर. सो ऑब्वियसली दिस विल बी योर फाइनल स्टेट. ओके, इन द बिगिनिंग वी कैन हैव एनी नंबर ऑफ बीज, आपके पास कितने भी बी हो सकते हैं. बट एज सून एज we get a single a, there is a chance that ab can again come. So I will go to the state q1 and again this is also a final state because we can have b a, it is also a final state. Now after this we can have any number of a's in this state. Yahan par bhi kitne bhi a aa sakte, we can have any number of a's. But if we get a b, agar yahan par mere paas ek b aayega then ab can be there, right? If we get a B, we'll go to the state Q3 and this Q3 is not a final state. And here we can have any combination of A and B. यहाँ पर मेरे पास A और B का कोई भी combination आ सकता है because once we get AB as a substring, then we do not want to accept anything. जैसे ही मेरे पास AB as a substring आ जाएगा, उसके बाद मुझे कुछ भी accept नहीं करना है. Okay? Now from this itself, you have some idea. आपके पास कुछ idea हो सकता है that what can be the solution. इसका solution क्या हो सकता है? Because I do not want AB as a substring. ठीक है, so we can have any number of B's, then we can have a single A, right? Here also we can have any number of A's, but after this if we get a B, अगर इसके बाद B आएगा, then I do not want to accept anything after that. मुझे वहाँ पर कुछ भी accept नहीं करना है. So from this, maybe you can get some idea. Sir, then the sir, the idea should be, my dear sir, the idea should be B star A, A star, right? Something like this can be there, right? ऐसा कुछ हो सकता है हमारे पास, right? But here this something more interesting because this is also not a correct solution. ये भी एक properly correct solution नहीं है because here epsilon is also accepted. यहाँ पर epsilon भी accept हो रहा है. Here epsilon is also accepted as well as here I can say B star is also accepted. So you can also say it this way, sir. Here we can also have a solution as B star. यहाँ पर B star भी एक solution है. This B star is also a solution. Why? Because here AB is not there. So in this solution, we have B star B. Right? So you have to add this B star in your solution, not just this part. You have to add this part, but you have to add this B star ko bhi add karna hai. So from this, entirely you can get a complete picture what is the solution. So this question was easy, right? It was not such a difficult question. All you have to do is you should first of all understand कि वो प्रॉब्लम में पूछना क्या चाहता है बिफोर सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चन प्रॉब्लम. क्लियर हुआ सबके साथ? क्लियर विद एवरीवन? सबसे पहला स्टेप ये है कि आपको ये समझना है कि पूछना क्या चाहता है. व्हाट डू दे वांट टू आस्क. वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट दे वांट टू आस्क, देन यू कैन टेक स्टेप्स टू सॉल्व इट. ठीक है. Now obviously I can take one more example before I finish off this class. I can take one more example and maybe you can give me the solution of that example. So the example is something like this. The language is, what should I take? So the language here that I'm taking here is no two A's and no two B's should come together. So let me also rub this one. I'm going to write it as no two B's should come together. And this problem is based on summation is equal to A, comma B. Now again, this is your problem. I don't want to give you the solution, right? So this is again your problem and you have to solve this one. Okay, so I will explain this one. From this, aapka jo previous case hai, your previous case will become easier. Just by taking this example, aapka jo previous case hai, because some of you might be having a doubt in the previous one, ki sir, aapne DFA se kaise kar diya? Sir, how you solved it from DFA, sir? You are such an intelligent guy, sir. How can you solve the क्वेश्चन विद DFA? आप उस क्वेश्चन को DFA से कैसे सॉल्व कर सकते हैं, राइट? फाइन. सो इन दिस केस आई कैन, ओके, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन इन दिस मैनर. सो नो टू A's एंड नो टू B's शुड कम टूगेदर. दिस इज योर प्रॉब्लम कि ना तो दो A और ना ही दो B एक साथ A आने चाहिए. कोई भी दो A और एक साथ दो B नहीं होना चाहिए. जैसे कि हमारे पास कोई स्ट्रिंग है, इफ यू हैव डबल A B A. So here this string should not be present in the language because here two A's are coming. So what are the strings that can be present in this language? Kya kya string ho sakti hai? So strings can be, we can have a single A, we can have epsilon, we can have a single B, we can have AB, we can have ABA, we can have BA, we can have BAB, we can have ABAB, we can have ABABA. We can have B A B A B. We can have B A B A B A, right? We can also have B, A, B, A, and so on, right? So these kind of strings are present in the language. So if you analyze all of these strings, there is a few properties. Kuch properties hai. What are the properties? Here, either the string is starting with A and ending with B, or the string is starting with A as well as ending with A, or the string is starting with B and ending with B, or the string is starting with B and ending with A, or the string is starting with A and ending with B, starting with A, ending with A, starting with B, ending with B, starting with B, ending with A, starting with B, ending with A, and so on. So first of all, you should understand. First of all, you should understand what is the characteristic of the problem. Right? So aapke paas strings available hai. What is the characteristic of that string? Now, by understanding the characteristic of that string, you are ready to solve it. ठीक है, आप इसको सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. हाउ कैन यू डू इट, कैसे कर सकते हैं? देखो, सो वी हैव द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, राइट? सो आई एम गोइंग टू राइट इट दिस मैनर. सो आई हैव, दिस इज द स्टार्ट सिंबल, इट इज स्टार्ट्स विद, एंड दिस इज द एंड्स विद. ठीक है, सो वी हैव फोर केसेस. द फर्स्ट केस इज स्टार्टिंग विद ए, एंडिंग विद ए. सेकेंड इज स्टार्टिंग विद ए, ending with B. Third is starting with B, ending with A. And the fourth is starting with B as well as ending with B also. Starting or ending so symbols hai, wo same hai. Theek hai? Clear? Is it clear with everyone? Good. Now, in this case, what are the combinations present? We can have a single A, we can have A, B, A, we can have A, B, A, B, A, we can have A, B, A, B, A, B, A, and so on. In the second combination, we can have the strings which are A, B, we have A, B, A, B, we can have A, B, so here we can have A, B, A, B, A, B, and so on. In this third combination, what are the strings which are possible? We can have BA, we can have BA, BA, we can have BA, 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 and so on. In this fourth combination, we can have the strings which is single B, BA, B, BA, BA, B, and so on. These are the strings. Okay? तो ये सभी स्ट्रिंग्स यहाँ पर प्रेजेंट है. सो इफ यू लुक एट ऑल ऑफ दीज सब प्रॉब्लम्स, बिकॉज सॉल्विंग द बिगर प्रॉब्लम वाज डिफिकल्ट, बट सॉल्विंग दीज सब प्रॉब्लम्स इज मच इजियर. ये सब प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व करना काफी ज्यादा आसान है. सो द फर्स्ट केस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग एज ए बी ए स्टार. हाउ आई गॉट दिस? सो वी हैव बिगनिंग विद ए, एंडिंग विद, वी हैव बी ए विच इज रिपीटिंग. बी ए जो है वो यहाँ पर रिपीट कर रहा है. सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग ए बी ए स्टार, और इट कैन ऑल्सो बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन वन मोर मैनर. इसको हम एक और तरीके से भी रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते थे. सो इट कैन कुड हैव बीन रिप्रेजेंटेड एज ए बी ए स्टार और ए बी स्टार ए. हाउ कैन आई डू इट सर? हाउ कैन यू डू इट सर? आप कैसे कर सकते हैं? हाउ कैन यू डू इट? इट इज़ वेरी इजी माई डियर फ्रेंड्स. रिमेंबर, इन द बिगिनिंग, in the beginning of the lecture, I've given you some identities. मैंने आपको कुछ identities दी थी. I've given you some identities in just in the beginning of the lecture. I've given you, I told you that we have R, right? So and S. I've told you that we have R, S, R star. Something like this I've given you. Then I can also write as R, S star and R. In the beginning of the lecture itself, I've given you some identity like this. If you remember it clearly, just follow through the PPTs. Go back to the PPTs, you'll understand. I've given you something like this. Okay. So, what is the next one here? This is the first one. What will the next one? So, next one says that we have AB, 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 and so on. So, that means here it is representing AB plus. Okay, ye yahan par AB plus ko represent kar raha hai because we do not have an epsilon here. Yahan par aapke paas epsilon nahi hai. Okay. Clear? And this AB plus can also be written in one more manner. It can also be written as, I hope it is visible on this side. Yes, it is visible. So it can also be written in this manner.
that it is A and B in the end, and in the beginning we have B A star. Beginning middle mein aapke paas B A star ho sakta hai. This can also be written in this manner. Theek hai? So because here you can clearly see, here we have B A, here we have B A and B A and so on. So I'm just trying to identify the pattern which is repeating, right? In the same way, this third case where beginning with B and ending with A, it can be represented as B A plus, or it can also be represented in this manner. So we can take this A B in middle, right? So it can also be represented by B A B star. Here we have A. Okay. In the same way, the last one here can be represented as last one. कैसे represent कर सकते हैं? Here we have AB, so which is repeating. AB which is repeating. So you can also represent this as B AB star, which can also be written as BA star B. हम इसको कुछ इस तरीके से भी लिख सकते हैं. So therefore, when I say we have final solution, what is your final solution? What is your final solution? Just add all of them. Add them, then you will get your final solution. आपको अपना final solution जो है इनको add करने से मिल जाएगा. Okay? So what I'm doing here is I'm writing this one, which is AB whole star A plus. I'm also writing this one. मैं इसको यहाँ पर लिख सकता हूँ. Why I'm writing this one? Because I can take something as common, right? I'm taking this part. I'm taking this part. So which is A BA star B plus. I'm taking this part here, which is B AB star A plus. I'm taking, so here we have BA and then we also have AB. So yahan par aapke paas BA hai. So here we have AB plus. Okay, so maybe I can take something else as common. So when I say that we have AB plus, so this AB plus I could also have written this one more manner, which is AB star dot AB. मैं इसको AB star dot AB भी लिख सकता हूँ. I can also write it this in this manner, I think, right? Yes. And here I have AB as well as in the last one I can take AB. So we have B dot AB star. तो यहाँ से भी B dot AB star को लिख सकते हैं. Okay. I hope it is clear. आप सभी के साथ ये clear होगा, right? So what I can do here is after this, I also have to add something more to this, which is epsilon, because initial state is also a final state, right? Because in epsilon, no two A's and no two B's are coming together, so epsilon should also be there. ठीक है? Therefore, you can minimize it after this. You can take AB as common. You can take AB as common. Maybe you can take AB as common from there. And then you can try and minimize. And in the same way, you can take different combination of this side. In me say, आप कुछ अलग-अलग combination भी ले सकते हैं. You can take a different combinations from this side, and then you can, you know, try to see how can you minimize this expression. तो इस expression को minimize करना भी possible है, right? So it is minimizing this expression is also possible. Right, Priyanka, what I am doing here is whatever I am finding that is repeating itself, I am just putting that thing in the start. That's it. और कुछ नहीं करना. जो भी आपको ऐसा लगता है कि रिपीट कर रहा है उसको स्टार में रख दो. That's it. जैसे यहाँ पर BA is repeating, BA is repeating, BA, 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 BA. So I'm just putting this BA in star. That's it. So just do one thing, Priyanka, because you are facing difficulty. So I would recommend you that do one thing after the class, try to revise this entire video. Because जो आपकी next class है, that is minimization, I mean conversion of finite automata to RE and RE to finite automata. You will face difficulty in your next class because you have not studied this one. आपने इसको properly अगर आपको समझ में नहीं आया, because you are not able to understand this class. So obviously you will face difficulty in your next class. आपको आपकी अगली class में difficulty face होगी. ठीक है? So that is why I'll recommend you कि after the class, just rewind this entire class from the beginning. फर्स्ट से रीड करो, आपको सब कुछ समझ में आएगा. यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग. ठीक है? बिकॉज आई थिंक इवन इफ आई ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन यू दिस, देन यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. मे बी यू हैव स्किप्ड अ फर्स्ट फ्यू मिनट ऑफ द क्लास. आपको शायद बिगनिंग में आई हैव कवर्ड समथिंग दैट यू माइट हैव स्किप्ड. so that is why you're not able to understand, or maybe I'm teaching very fast. Aisa bhi ho sakta hai, that is also possible, right? There's a possibility that I'm teaching very fast. That can also be a case, okay? So, fine. So let's take a break right now. I don't know what is the time. The time is 8:30 approx. It is 8:30. Okay? And Priyanka, just follow through the lectures. I mean, just do a revision of the lecture. You will be able to understand. Or do one thing after this. Maybe during the break time, आप इसको दोबारा से स्टडी करने की कोशिश कर सकते हैं. ठीक है आसिफ, इफ़ यू आर ऑल्सो फेसिंग डिफिकल्टी, आई थिंक योर आंसर इज करेक्ट, आई बिलीव आपका आंसर ठीक होगा. सो इफ यू आर फेसिंग एनी डिफिकल्टी इन दिस लेक्चर, तो यू कैन जस्ट रिवाइज इट एंड देन लेट मी नो. इफ यू स्टिल फेस डिफिकल्टी आफ्टर द ब्रेक, तो मैं आपको नेक्स्ट सेशन में आई विल कवर दिस टू एग्जाम्पल्स अगेन. अगले सेशन में दोनों एग्जाम्पल को दोबारा से कवर कर दूंगा. ठीक है, तो लेट्स टेक अ ब्रेक. ठीक है, विल टेक अ ब्रेक एंड देन विल मीट अगेन. सो विल डू अवर नेक्स्ट सेशन. इट इज 8:30 राइट नाउ एंड विल स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट सेशन बाय मे बी आई शुड स्टार्ट बाय 9 or 9:30. आई विल अपडेट इन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप कि नेक्स्ट सेशन का टाइमिंग क्या है. आई विल अपडेट देयर इन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप एंड देन वी कैन मीट. ठीक है.